Hi everyone. This is a live recording on ustream.tv.com. If you're joining me live, we have Fibs in the box that I'm chatting with. I am not talking to myself, at least not right now. And if you're seeing the recording, please come over and join us. We'd like to have you with us in a live chat. Today I'm going to be doing a journal page in my magazine journal, and be using all kinds of goodies. So go ahead and find my page. Where did I decide I was going to go? I think it was here. It was more flat. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to prepare my paper. Where is my cutter? Sorry if my head gets in the way, guys. I still working out camera angle. All right. Well, cut a little short. Okay. Oh, let me get this out of my way. Oh, let me get this open. Hold on a minute, guys. My glasses just popped out. Yeah, there we go. Time to tighten the screw. Okay. Don't be quiet, y'all, because I gotta pay attention to what I'm doing. Oh, there's two in there. All right, well, we'll just use one. We'll have enough room for all that. All right, make sure all the stickers are ready. Stencils. And I'm just going to be doing a one-page spread instead of a double. Get out my, gluing this down with gel medium. Yeah, I'm mixed. It depends. Like, some of my pages here are doubles. It depends on what I'm doing. Like, this is a double. These are all singles. Double, I don't like that one. These are singles. That one's nothing. But, like, this one's a double. It just depends on what I'm doing. This is my experimental journal. It's made using two magazines. Right? I hear you, LG. Yeah, I'm on a spending freeze for a couple more months until October. I can't buy nothing. Because I just bought a house a couple months ago, so. And I just had my roofer come out and give me an estimate on, I have one spot in my roof that needs to be re-tacked down and stuff. $800. Hi, Carol. So yeah, definitely on a spending freeze for a couple more months, until I get something paid off. And then I am going to invest in some stuff or more stuff. So October. Yeah. Cause, like I said, some things, you know, I gotta pay a bill off before I can, you know, to make sure I make all my bills monthly. I can't spend any extra money, but, definitely want to invest in, like, some fluid acrylics and some other stuff that I've been needing. And need is the word. It's not a necessarily just a want. It's a need. So. All right. So, go ahead and. Get started here. This is, definitely an experimental page. I don't know how it'll come out. But we shall see. And I'm just using soft gel for this. And there's a reason why, and you'll see in a minute, I think. And then we're going to wait, I want to put the heart in first. You know what, I can just draw it on there. Oh, where is my cheat sheet? I drew out a portion of what I wanted on there. So, okay. I need to... We'll just estimate. I think that should do it. Some of this you're not going to see once I'm done with it. That's the joy of layers. Give me a minute. I'll catch up to chat in a minute, guys. to get, here is it, some washi tape in here. That's good. I wish I had more than other stickers, but I don't. All right, that's fine. All right, baby wipe. Now this next trick I picked up from watching Effie Wilde. I love her. I got a whole box of sprays. And let's see, I think I'm going to use a stencil. This is just a fuchsia spray. This is a homemade alcohol ink. Well, this stencil, I did not end up liking this one. Should have went with my other first choice. Where is that? Oh, crud. Where's my paper? Bear with me, guys. All right. Let them dry over there. Yeah, that's good. Okay. Now I'm going to dry this. Heat gun. Now give me a minute to catch up on chat. Who do we got here? A couple of anonymouses. Renee, are you talking about me? The Happy Meal? Yeah, my 19-year-old still lives with me, LG. Oh, that stencil, that was a Crafters Workshop stencil, I believe. It's just circles, within circles, within circles. I think it's by Crafters Workshop. Well, thank you, Renee. I can't wait to get it. It'll be exciting. Yeah, I'm going to be starting my my Create from Happy Meal Packages projects here soon, this week, actually. I got the idea from Lori Richardson Haley, where she takes the Happy Meals that she gets, and she creates something from just using the Happy Meal, with the exception of like paints and inks and stuff like that. Thanks, Toby. So I'm going to be starting a series on that because I have a couple Happy Meals I've received. So no rush, Renee. That'll be awesome. Just whenever. Yeah, I wish this stencil had come out a little more apparent. I think that I that ink just was too runny for that stencil, because you can't see some of the shape of the circles. Well, you enjoy your vacation, Renee. That's awesome. Are you guys doing a Disney World Disney and that while you're down there? Oh, Mildred, we swap. If Mildred, if you want to email me, I'll give you my email address and I'll put you on my mailing list. I personally am creating a mailing list for my Ustream friends and some of my friends on YouTube, so I can send stuff every once in a while. But a lot of times the ladies will do swaps and stuff. But if you want to email me, and I'll give you my email here in a minute. Oh, I got to turn on links. Hold on a minute. Sorry. All right, you should be able to link now. Oh, well, that'll be fun. Yeah, I did some of the preliminary work for this page because I knew that there was going to be some drawing time involved. So I'm like, the more time I save by prepping some of the other stuff. Mildred, there's my email if you want to get on my mailing list. Sure, LG, there's my email. Just go ahead and email me with your real first and last name and your address. I've got some other people. I already did round one, and I'm already have a list started for round two. So that's another thing. I got to get to making some more postcards. I like sending postcards over ATCs because it gives me more real estate to work with when I'm arting and creating. So I like to send postcards. But I usually send other stuff with it. I don't know if we'll finish this page today, but we will try. I'm going to use lots of fun goodies on this page. I have my oil pastels, which I love using. I'm going to use a little bit of Stabilo on the page, and some paints and sprays. And oh, thank you. All right, this is dry enough. It's good enough. It's dry. Okay, I'm gonna get my baby wipe here. I'm gonna just kind of scrub some of this back, and the gel medium. The reason why I used it is that it keeps, if you have sprays that are water soluble and you put it into the wet gel medium, I learned this from Effie Wild, and then you dry it, it kind of keeps some of it kind of permanent-ish. That's even a word, permanent-ish. Then, because it's blue, it allows you to push some of it back. All right. I mean, it won't totally keep it from running, but as you see, it's kept a lot of it in there. Okay. I need to make some paint because, again, I don't have fluid acrylics. So, I'm going to make some paint colors. And if you don't know and you want to I understand that, Carla. If you don't have fluid acrylics and you want to use your opaque paint, make sure that you use thank you, Carla. It was nice to see that on stream the other day. I was like, aw. you can use lasing fluid to make your paints more fluid and more translucent. Where's my correct brush? This is my correct brush. I shouldn't have put that on there yet. I'm gonna make another color. Just like that. Until I get the other color ready. Can you say that on Ustream? Maybe I won't be able to put this recording up on YouTube. And I'm making way too much paint, but that's okay. Pretty soon I won't have to do this. Well. Only have blocks at a time. Yeah. Art can be tough, Captain, when you got a busy schedule. I have my yellow, I have my, ooh, crap, I'm making a mess. Hold on, guys. Okay. And the magenta. And I need another paintbrush. I really need to get some little jars. Now we're ready to paint. And this one here. And I'm just kind of putting it on crazy right now because it doesn't matter. Now I'm going to get ready to make a mess. Now, if Jean was here, she wouldn't like the drippage, but she would like where this paint is going to end up. Hi, Ella. I'm over here making a mess. Can you guys see the mess? Yeah, you guys can see the mess. All right. All right, now I'm going to dry this. Heat gun, in the words of Paula. Kathy, did I say hi? You are ready? Catching up on chat. Yeah, the stomach issues is probably from all the medication. How's the back though? You getting around okay? Yeah, when I had my surgery, I didn't even, after like, I think it was like 5 days, I stopped taking the medication. It was just, Well, first of all, they put me on two different painkillers, a steroid, anti-inflammatory, and something else. So, after 5 days of that, I was like, no, this is not going to happen. I hate taking medication as it is. So. I love watching paint dry. Just one corner. All right, good enough. Too much crap on my desk. All right, so now I'm going to put some texture, more texture on this page. I'm gonna use some stamps. Where's my own? Okay, let me take a drink, guys. Now my next card is a little trick that I don't know. Somebody else probably already thought of it before me. It's just something that I do. Because I'm not a good... I can't draw a crooked line. But if I sit down and I draw something and it turns out halfway decent, and you don't have graphite paper, you can do this little cheat that I'm doing. I take and I draw out my design, and then I trace it onto the quick wrap or the Dixie deli paper. So yeah, if you, Mildred, if you try to draw, or if you practice drawing and you like something, you can do what I'm doing. You can either get some graphite paper, which is the easier thing, and you guys still can't see this. Well, you'll see when I sketch it out. So I take it and I transfer it to this really thin deli paper that we use for jelly plating. and I draw it out on here, and it's see-through. It's translucent, so you can see through it. And then I take this pen, is a food ball pen, and the ink is very, very vivid. The problem is that it's pigment ink. So it says it's water and fade proof, but it takes forever and ever and ever to dry. But what I discovered is that I can use it to trace on my deli paper, and it will leave a faded imprint on my page that I can use to complete the draw in and shade in. So that way I don't goof up my page. I'm transferring it to that page and I can put it where I want it. Also, it allows you to audition your drawing. So I'm going to do that now. Can't look at chat now, guys. Well, oh yeah. That'll do. Right. Heat gun. Thanks, Ella. Yeah, I'm sure somebody thought of it before me. Because the time you go out, I mean, you know, tracing paper, graphite paper, you know, sure, it's easy and it's not too terribly expensive, but why buy an extra product that you don't need if you don't have to? But the key is two things, the deli paper and the right kind of pen. You have to have a pen that's rich in pigment so it bleeds through the deli paper. And I don't know if you guys can see it. Maybe if I hold the book up, but there's my slight outline of my drawing. But the pen on its own, I love the food ball, but they take forever to dry. But with this way, a lot of it's left on that tracing paper. So I only have a little bit here, so it should dry quickly. Usually does. Done. So far, so good. Alright. Now I'm going to get out my gold paints and let's see. You know what? Where's my punchinella? I was thinking that the holes were too big, but I think... So I have, this is drywall tape, and the holes are squared, but they're smaller than the punchinella, so I'm just trying to decide what I want to use. I want bigger circles or little tiny squares. What do y'all think? Punchinella or squares? I'm going to be stenciling gold onto the page. Nah, I think I'm going to go with Ella's suggestion and I'm going to use the punchinella. I like the drywall tape. I did that on a page yesterday or the day before. Maybe when we're done, I'll do a nice... Yeah, I like squares too. I like circles, but everybody does circles. And, you know, I actually do like the abstract squares. Do both have neither one? You're funny. Alright, put out some paint. Where's my stencil brush? Yeah, use this one. Got some ideas for this page. Not the focus, but some of the ideas and that I got from Effie Wild on Facebook. So it's kind of inspired by her, but the focal point and the idea was mine. And some of the stuff I'm going to be using is different than hers. Hi, buddy. Hi, Vicky. It's a journal page in my experimental journal. So, it was, and Terry's not here yet, but last weekend when we were watching Paula, and I got an idea, and I don't remember exactly why, but I know she was using, word stickers on her pages, and I got the idea at that time to use stickers on my page, and might not be able to see them too much. Well, here's one. So this is a sticker here. This is a sticker. There's some more up here underneath, and then I used some Tim Holtz tissue paper and some other stuff, and I glued that down. And while I used the soft gel medium, and while that was wet, I used a stencil to spray some spray inks in there. And then we dried that. And then I came in with some paint colors. And we just got done stenciling. That's where we're at. Yeah, I was showing the girls some, I thought about, because I'd done some ATCs where I put some stickers down and then I painted a whole page. I was just using cardstock, put the stickers down and painted over it, and then put normal embellishments and stuff on my ATCs. So because of that, and when we were last week in Paula's, I got the idea to do a page. And a page is kind of dedicated to Jean, who's not here. I was hoping that she would have came today. Thanks, Kathy. Now, Tim Holtz has a couple different tissue papers, unless they don't make them anymore, but let me show you. I love this stuff, and I need to get some more. He has two different kinds. This is the Ideology Melange. It's got some... Oh, here, I got a piece out. Let me get... Where did I put it? Oh, well. But see, it's got music and butterflies and moths and stuff on it. And it's really transparent. So you can color behind it or over it, and it works really great for putting on paper on your... adding layers and stuff and collage. I love collage. So, yeah, definitely, if you're looking for tissue paper, get some of this stuff. It's a little pricey, I will say that. I don't remember how much this box was, but I used my Michael's coupon to get this. I think it was like, I don't know, $10 or $15 or something. Yeah, I love that stuff. Okay, let's see, where was I? What was next? Okay, so now that I've put the Punchinella down and it's dry, I'm going to come in with a little bit more of colors. The colors I had going. Bring in a little more. Deepen up the colors a little bit. Again, we're going to let this run a little bit. Where's my other paintbrush? Paintbrush would be good. Oh, it's in my water. Time to make another mess. There we go. Renee, you're funny. All right, now I'm going to... dry this again. Heat gun. Oh, wow. Terry, you're talking about, right, Renee? Yeah, she's probably sleeping. If that's the case. That's what I said, Bunny. But she's probably trying to get in streams whenever she can because of her new stencil release. So, for those of you that may be watching on YouTube, be sure to check out Patty Toll Parish, icestencils.com for her new stencil release. If you want to come over and watch us on Ustream, she'll share those with you and you'll get to see the new designs. I know this doesn't look like much yet, guys, but it will, I promise. At least, I promise that, hope it turns out. No promises on that. It'll look like something, what I just don't know. That's okay, Renee. You'll be able to use all those in projects, and because you can use that on your ATCs and postcards, journal pages. Yeah, me too, Ella. She's got a lot of stencils out there that I need to get. Almost there. Yeah, that too, Ray. I did that with Carla, as she mentioned earlier. She said she needed papers, so I sent her some papers. A whole bunch, actually. And I think that she mentioned she might be sharing those in Happy Mail or a giveaway or something as well. They're just a very good base for pages. All right, dry enough. All right, so now I'm going to get out my Stabilo All pencil. Love this thing. You guys don't have any Stabilo, and I need to get the white, and I also want to get some China markers. They're great for detailing on your pages. They are not waterproof, so need to make sure that you're using them knowing that they're probably going to run if you put anything else on them. Unless they're the final layer, you know. But I'm going to be using some fixative on this page after I use the pencil. Right, Renee? Yeah. Yeah, I have a package. I gotta get that out. Oh, this is still a little damp down here. Yeah, the Stabilo pencils are really awesome. Like I said, I also want to get the China markers and the black and the white as well. Yeah, Mildred, don't try to keep track. You know what? Because if you're just starting out, not, you know. Kind of new or whatnot, you know, kind of just get some basic things that you know that you're gonna play with for a little bit and get used to how things work, and then just kind of integrate more stuff. You know, just use what you have and you know buy a little at a time until you figure out how everything works because not everything works together with everything. just going around a little bit, around the edges of some of the pieces that I put on the page, just to kind of give them dimension. Where is my brush? Making a mess again. Yeah, I can imagine, Ella. That's what I asked for Christmas is Amazon gift cards. My birthdays as well. Okay. So, made that a little runny. Try this. Is my stamp. I'll put a little bit more stamp on here. Put some texture. Blix is a paint store, Mildred. I mean, they carry other things too, but get a lot of the premium paints there. Yeah, Dicklets. They have a big store, a couple stores here in Illinois, in Chicago and Schaumburg nearby me. Okay, so I think I'm going to put on my spray fixative. This is just Spectrafix. It's a non-toxic indoor fixative. Yeah, I would agree with that, Kathy. Heat gun. Glad you're here. I'm dedicating this page to you and you've missed it. Not this page. Don't look at this page. But the one I'm working on. And you'll see why when it's done. I'm taking one out of your playbook. Just wait. You'll see. Don't look at the pink. It's kind of purplish now, though. Oh, wait, yeah. It's even better than that, Gene. Wait until I'm done. At least I hope it turns out somewhat decent. Yeah, it is here, too, Gene. It's horrible outside. Our index is like, well, it's kind of... It's not purple. Only down here is pink. And a little bit over here. But you can ignore the pink. But yeah, I think our heat index today is like 106 or something. It's horrid. Oh, yeah. You know, it's funny because, you know, when I started out last year and I ordered the heat gun, Amazon tells you it's random. Whichever one you're gonna get, you can't really pick one. I was kind of bummed about that because naturally I would have ordered like a different one other than green, because green is not really my favorite color. Although I've come to enjoy some greens now that I'm like knee deep in mixed media. So it's okay, but I'll trade, yeah. But not your one that blew up on you. I don't want that one. I live in Illinois, Ella. Okay. It's dry enough. All right. Now that I've completely made a mess, now let me see. I have notes over here, so hold on a minute. Okay, so... Now, I know this doesn't really kind of go, but where's my other stencil? Oh. Let me see. What do I want to do next? Give me a minute, guys. Thinking about what I want to do next. Yeah, I'm going to stencil some white on here. Brighten up the page a little bit. Not that one. That's my other one. Yeah, it's the heat is terrible. Oh crap. Hold on, guys.
going to tighten my glasses. My lens keeps popping out.
Hi, rat lady. Kathy, it depends on what you're doing with ATC. Like, for my ATCs, if I'm not painting directly on them and I'm doing gouache first, I usually use Mod Podge. It just really depends. You could use matte medium too. That's thin and won't, it's easier on, if you like using napkins, it's really easy on napkins. It just really depends. But if you're gluing down a thicker collage item, like cardstock or whatnot, on top of the ATC, you're going to want to use a little bit heavier body of glue. Now, this isn't as small as I wanted it, so I'm only going to put a couple. I wish I had the Tim Holtz Alpha Stencil. I just need to cut this one smaller. This one I cut with my Silhouette. Thank you. I don't know. We'll see how pretty it turns out in the end. I don't draw the greatest, and I'm still only a year into mixed media, so we'll see. All right. So let me dry the stencil. I don't tell anything anybody tells me. You almost missed all the fun. Well, maybe not so much fun. Oh, wow, Jean, that's awesome. Oh, she's gonna love that. No worries, Terry. I understand you're up late and Kathy, when I did the flowers on my ATCs, a little dab of the eyelids, I also used that as well. I put that on the back of flowers to adhere them down. Oh no, Terry, what happened? Oh. Okay. Now let's see. What do I want to do next? Let's add in a little more green to these letters. I just want to push them back a little bit. Making a mess. I know you don't like drippage, Gene, but it'll be all right, I promise. Well, again, I hope. Oh, no. I goofed that one up. I'm gonna have to re-stencil that. Guess I didn't let that one dry enough. Stencil this, guys. Maybe we'll change it a little bit. Maybe we'll. No, I think I still like it. That. Let's put down. I kind of wanted it to go sideways. I didn't do that the first time, so now I have option. Heat gun. Yeah, I'm dedicating this page to Gene. You'll see why when it's all finished. I took one out of her playbook. Yeah, this is my magazine experimental journal that I did a YouTube video on that I've been doing pages on. If we have time, or once the recording is over, we'll do a flip through and you guys can see some of the pages I've done. Not this page. I'm just doing a one-page spread today. Yeah, we were talking about you, Terry. Because remember, last weekend we were at Paula's, I said I had a project idea in mind. So, what I did, Terry, was, it's underneath all of this, and you can see some of it on the pages, like right here's one. But I took some of my old scrapbooking stickers. This is a sticker here. And I put that, and I adhered that down with some of the other papers that I have. So if you guys have scrapbooking stickers that you don't use, you can use them in your mixed media. But you can paint over them and... All right. Now let's deal with this. Yep, and I was showing the lady some of my ATCs that I did making graffiti paper background. Oh, crap. You want to make ATCs with it. It's really nice using it for ATCs. So you take your cardstock or whatever, and you put your stickers down and paint over it, and then you can cut it up into... I'll show you as soon as I'm done with Paige. Yeah, definitely. And it uses up all your old stock, because what are you going to do with it? You know, if you don't scrapbook much anymore. I don't. So I started doing that not too long ago. Yeah, me too, Carrie. I'm definitely into the boho graffiti. I'm not too much into drippage. I like it on some things. Like, I did it a little bit on this page because I wanted the colors to kind of blend together. But this definitely looks like something that could be up on a brick wall in the city. And it'll definitely look better once I'm done. And then I shared a couple tricks with the ladies. How to transfer a drawing to your page. I'm just gonna dry this. And then I'm gonna fill in the rest of the drawing and paint in. And that's dry enough. This poor page has gone through the ringer. Well endowed, huh, Jean? Well endowed. Oh. That's got to be rough, Mildred. What do you do in the wintertime? Well, where do you live? Is it always warm there? Oh, wow, Jean. Big hug, Jean. Big hug. All right. Now we are going to finish the page. I hope. Where is my pen? Wait, before I do that, let me get my messy paintbrushes out of the way and into my water. Get this out of the way. All right. I'm going to, where is my cranberry red? Oh, there it is. Right. Timber, everybody, timber. Craft a lunch. Seriously, though. Okay, so I think, yeah, let me paint the inside first. Where's my small brush? Small brush would be good. Hi, LP. Welcome to the party. I take my glasses off so I can't watch chat, guys. Can't wait to get some real paint. Do not buy Grimbacher or Artist Loft. They're okay, but not the greatest of paints. But they're affordable. Sorry if my head's in the way, guys. Steady hand is a must, but yeah, not this girl. Gotta hold it up, guys. Sorry. You guys want a really good pen? These Uniball pens are the bomb. Take a minute to catch up on chat. It's the Uniball Signal. I have it in, they have it in all kinds of colors. Any of the Uniball pens, these are great pens for journaling because they're permanent once they dry. So I have gold, silver, white, and black. And my I'd be lost without my black one, for real. Yes, Jean, definitely love these pens. These are the bomb for journaling. So before I go any further, I've still got a couple other things. I'm going to be using some oil pastels here in a minute. But can you all guess the theme of the page? Come on, Jane, you should get this one. Nope. No, Ella. Very good, Terry. Awesome. Yeah. No, Unchained Melody. Yes, Terry. Yeah, this is going to be a lock, but I thought with the music theme and, you know, pulling, you know, a cue out of Jean's playbook with the whole music and everything, I thought this is a chain wrapped around the music, and it's unchained now. Yeah, so do I. Righteous Brothers are awesome. Yeah. Oh, I'm sorry. You know what? I can't get it fully in screen, but here it is. I know it's kind of sideways. But yeah, there's music all in through here. The stickers and the tissue paper, and I drew in the chain here. And you like it, Dean? Yeah, this is dedicated to you. I got to finish. There's a couple other things I want to do yet. So I'm going to get out some of my oil pastels because I love these things. And show you how I use them. Let's see. Got to take off my glasses. I'm just going to put a little bit in certain spots. Kind of bring in a little bit of contrast in the heart before I finish drawing on it. And then what I do to get them to move, I don't know if it's the proper way, but it's the way that I do it. And I found that it's really, really simple. Now you can use water with these, but then it dilutes the color. So I picked this up from a tip on a YouTube for a lawyer, Lori Richardson Haley, and she showed me to do it this way. So heat gun on and off. And you just want to heat it a little bit until it, you can see that it gets glossy. It just richens up the color. Where is my, did I draw it on here? Oh, I didn't draw it on here. Hold on, guys. I gotta get my template. So what I do, you guys can't see. Well, let me do it on the page. So on this heart template, I drew a little keyhole. And because the tissue paper is translucent, I can use it to trace. And then the other pen that I have, and I only use it mainly for what I'm going to do next, is the Foodball pen. It's a pigment ink. It takes forever to dry, so I really only use it for tracing. And like I was saying earlier, this might have been thought up by somebody else already, but what it does is it bleeds through the tissue paper and gives me a slight imprint lines so I don't draw on there and make a mistake. And then I can take my signal. I don't know if you guys are seeing this. Sorry if I was out of frame, guys. And then I got... All right, where's my glasses? All right. Oh, crap. What do I got on my hand? This should be my black one. There we go. All right. Okay. So the only thing that's left for me to do is add my sentiment. I could have even made it more kind of grungier. I was going to do that, but then I forgot. But I like taking a like Titan buff or white or even a like other color and using my roller to roll on my pages to kind of make them grungy. Thanks, Jean, for answering, Terry. Sorry, I missed your question, hon. Yeah, I should have. I was thinking about maybe putting some white scrubbing down the page, but I don't want it to I don't want it to cover up my drawing. I should have done it before I finished my drawing. And actually, I have a couple more links here to fill in that I missed. All right. Well, now that I've made a mess, we've got 15 minutes left. So what do you guys think? Come out okay? How do I keep up with all this stuff? You know what? I don't really watch TV. I don't think I've really sat down and watched TV in like a year and a half. I watch YouTube. I keep up with the ladies and I keep up, you know, try to keep up on how to use new products and stuff. I love watching art and I love watching what people are doing and getting ideas and then kind of, you know, coming up with my own ideas or what I think may be my own ideas because I don't see anybody else doing it and incorporating it into my own art. So I think I may have to fill in the lock a little bit here so it's a little more apparent. I'm going to add the sentiment up here, and I'm going to write on this page that's dedicated to you, Jean. yeah, so that'll be that. But I promised you guys a flip through of some of the ones that I've done already. Up my mess a little bit here. So we'll do that. Oh, and my recent ATC, well, not too recent, but my ATCs that I did. I haven't always been single, Jean, but I've been divorced now for, well, this is 2016, so 16 years almost. So definitely single on purpose. You're funny, LP. Just catching up on chat a little bit, guys. Okay. So, Terry, these are the ATCs that you missed. These were done on just cardstock, and I put stickers in the back. And if up close you can see them, but I don't know if you guys are going to be able to see them on here, the stickers in the background. But there are stickers, and you can kind of see them. And then I painted over them, and then I laid down napkin, and then I stenciled. And then I embellished, and the embellishments, the little birds I made myself using baby wipes and cutting them on my silhouette. And then these are paper flowers. And then the nests are, I was telling the ladies, I take a modeling paste and I scrunch up string and put it in there, and then I spray ink it. To make it look like a nest. So I made those. The second one. outline the birds with my Stabilo. Oh, Carol, you're going to have to share on Twitter your jelly prints. I'd love to see them. Thanks, guys. So let's do a quick flip through, and then I can stop the recording and finish my page. This was a stream I did. This is going to get stuck in here, my little froggy. Thanks, guys. You're welcome, Terry. Hi, Mitzi. Mitzi, if you're just coming in, so this is the page that we did today. Can you guess what the theme is? Well, maybe if I bring that closer. All right, so we'll do a quick flip through and then I can stop the recording because I have 10 minutes left. So this is the very first page I did in my journal when I made it, and it's just it's made out of using two National Geographic magazines that I put together. So that's the first page. Second page. Nah. And this one is all about perspective. This is my third. Some of these are when I say third, that's just because it's the third page of the book. That's not the third page that I did. This picture, this is the magazine here. I didn't draw this. And in this picture is a moth looking through a window, and there's a dog right there. And it says, it's all a matter of perspective. So I kind of went with that. No, Terry, that is handmade texture. That I just put down gesso and brought in my colors and just kind of really scratched it in, but it's over a napkin. So the napkin helps give the paint the texture to make it look like Citrusol. Yeah, so, yeah, that's another thing, and I don't know if anybody else has done that before, but, you know, just cover your page with napkin, you know, gesso it, cover it with a napkin. It doesn't matter, any napkin, because you're going to cover it. And then take paint and just kind of just really scrub it in after you've glued it down, and it gives that faded texture feel. This is the one that I said I had done a week before Jean did her fishy stream. Of course, hers looks better. No, Jean, yours is way better than mine. Definitely. And this one, my little snail. This was just this was scrap bits of a jelly plated paper on a black background and jelly plated circles. This was definitely an abstract piece. What glue did I use for the napkin? Thanks. if you're talking about the napkin, Terry, yeah. Generally with napkin, because it's so thin, there's a couple different things. If I'm just using the napkin as it is, then I will use the matte medium because it's a nice thin liquid for napkin. But if I'm going to glue a whole bunch of napkins on a project or something, I might water down some PVA or Mod Podge. But if the napkin, one of my other things that I do is you can take a napkin, and if it has a light colors on it, like, okay, so if you have a black napkin, you don't want anything that's black or really dark in color. But if you have a napkin that's white with, you know, a design on it and you want to make it translucent, you can take the napkin, put some Daddy Vans on it, both sides, and it'll make it translucent. So if the napkin is translucent, it has that wax on it, I may use a Mod Podge or definitely a PVA. Because the Daddy Vans wax makes it easier to work with and not so fragile. But I liked yours better, Jean. Definitely liked yours better. All right, so I definitely love, again, the scratchy, muted look. These are done with some paints and definitely my wax pastels. I love them. I love those things. And I only have the 24 set, or oil pastels rather, from the Crayola. I want to get a big set. Oh my God. When October comes, I'm definitely going to get me a full set of pastels, all colors. This is a nothing page. Haven't done anything with it yet. It's my little birdie. On here is background and stenciling over the napkin. So it had some colors on it, and then I just took a napkin, put it on there, and drew out the flowers. This is done with paints and oil pastels. This is one of my favorites. Oh, and another tip, guys, once you're done with your pages and you've sealed them, if you use a little bit of the Daddy Vans wax on there, it'll keep them from sticking. So let's go to the back. This is my retro vintage page. This is the was already in the magazine. Yes, I drew the bird. I didn't think it was that cute. You guys liked it? Yeah, it didn't really come out how I envisioned it. So I wasn't really happy with it. This is another technique you guys could do too. If you take the really thin Dixie deli wrap and you use a repositional glue stick and adhere just the top of it to a regular copy paper and run it through your printer, you can print on the deli paper, and that's what these are. All three of these were printed from images from the computer and printed on deli paper. Thank you for coming, Kathy. What wax? Got this from Shannon Green. It's Daddy Vans All Natural Unscented Furniture Polish. Ding! And it will keep all your pages from sticking once you've sealed it. So make sure you seal them. This is just an abstract piece. This was a magazine image. This is one of my favorites, too. I do MRL because the paint, you know, your book is together. They're going to stick together. And even after you seal them, they maybe have to stick together less than just without the sealant. But it protects the paint. It protects your work. I seal with Mod Podge, and a really thin layer, and it gives it a nice. It allows the texture to come through. You could use, Didi suggests to use the Ceram Coat, this stuff. The Ceram Coat Delta Varnish. And I tried that a few times, and I just find that it's very thick. And then, because it's so thick, I feel that you lose a lot of the texture in your pages. And if I'm going to go through all the trouble to put all that texture into my pages, I had to find a different sealer that worked for me. So for me, I seal them with Mod Podge, nice thin layer, nice even. And then I dry it, and the paint will not move, and it really seals them nice, and it keeps the pages from being too thick. And then once it's dry, I put a really thin layer of the wax on there. Yeah, I use water-soluble media. The oil pastels are water-soluble. At least these are. I want to get the permanent ones, but these are. I have some gelatos that I may use from time to time. The Stabilo. And this is what I use to fix it. This is a indoor spectrofix fixative. It'll seal your work, but it's non-toxic, so you can use it inside. Yeah, Terry, definitely. Whatever works for you. Yeah, I don't know. I have no problem with the Mod Podge. I mean, all these pages are all Mod Podged, all of them. And they don't stick. They don't, you know, there's no sticking going on here. So I use that in the wax and I'm good. Oh, I'll have to try that, Renee. Yeah, but how much does that cost? And what size bottle is it? Because, you know, Mod Podge is, you know, $6 for the big jar. You don't have to bear, Mildred. Like Jean said, you know, you're just using, you know, craft paint. You're just fiddling around in a book. You don't want to waste the time to seal them. Although this is my experimental journal, all the work in here, I do want to save it, so I don't want it to have problems later. Yeah, everybody does something different. You don't have to, Mildred. It's entirely a personal thing. I like to seal my work, and that's just me. This page right here, this page, was a pita. It was a pita. And so each one of these circles is not just a circle. It's not. Some of them are painted, and some of them are napkins, but they're layered. So it took a long time to get this page done. It's not just simply painting the background and, you know, or putting something down and then painting around it. There are several different colors. This is all, whoop. Each one of those different colored circles is circled in and painted, but not by themselves. It's all layered. And my little house is page. No, they're not punched, Terry. What I do is I put down, let's say, napkin, right? And then I'll draw a circle, and I'll pick the color I want, and I paint that all around except for the circles. And then, now you have a new color on your page. And then you do the same thing again, or you put down more napkins, and you just keep, you know, filling in with all the different colors and keep just doing the circles. But it takes a lot, it's a long process. Depending on how many layers, how many different colors you want to incorporate, you know, because like the yellow and the red wasn't done at the same time, or the purple and the blue. Thank you. These are actually collaged. This was a coffee cup, this one here, but I made it into a house. Yeah, it is a PETA. It's a long process, but it's fun, and I'm glad I did it. I don't know how often I will do that, but it was fun. This is just a background page. Some of them I just did backgrounds because I don't know if I'm ever going to do anything with them, but I was just fiddling around. The Krylon is nice, but you have to use it outside. Any of the aerosol spray fixatives really need to be sprayed outside because they're toxic. You got little houses on one of your pages? Yeah, but that was a long day for sure, Terry. okay, so this is scrap bits of paper where the cutouts were. And I just adhered them down, colored them in, doodled, stamped, and used tissue paper and stencils. This is another one of my favorites. This is the only page so far. This is the first page that actually has a sentiment on it or actual journaling. I'm not a big journaler. So I don't really call my journals necessarily. I think they're more considered art books at this point because I don't really do a whole lot of journaling. I did this one yesterday. Love this page. Yeah, they're lotus flowers, hand painted and drawn. Now, last one is just excess paint. That's what I'll do a lot when I'm working in the book. I will put excess paint on a nearby page. And I just kind of like how this came out, so I don't think I'll ever do anything with this either. Do I like birds? I do. I like flowers, butterflies, turtles, and flowers are my favorites. But I do like birds. I'm trying to find a way for myself to learn how to draw them. I would love to draw birds and faces. But I definitely love animals. Art journaling, since the beginning, Terry. So I found mixed media last year, July, and our wonderful Patty Tully Parrish, God love her, master enabler, extraordinaire, got me into doing the clay. And then from there, I got into the painting and stuff. Because I mean, I used to do stuff when I was younger, when I was a kid. And so watching videos, I got into the art journaling. And so now I've been doing it since about, October of last year. I agree, Jean. That's why I say art journaling. Some people would call it art journaling. Someone would call it, just an art book. But for me, they're journals because, this is my progress. This is the first journal that I've kept up with. I've got a couple other ones. I had bought like the small dilutions and goofed up some of the pages and didn't really like them. And then I created a couple handmade journals that didn't come out so great. But this is the one that I've been sticking with. I like this size. This is National Geographic is. Where's my ruler? So it's a 7 by 10. And the very first page, let me show you guys. This is the very first page I ever did. Because I also bought the, I bought the Canson Mixed Media 9 by 12 book. And my very first page, see if it would not be shimmery. And it says, she flies with wings of her own. And that sentiment is me. I am very quirky. I'm very different. I was born and raised in Oregon, and butterflies being my favorite, and the insect for that state. And that is the state phrase or saying for Oregon. One of these days, I'm going to get that phrase tattooed with a butterfly on my shoulder. Yeah. I don't know about that, Terry. I still feel like I'm a new, and I'm still learning. My frustration right now with myself is, it's not the colors. It's, well, for me, it's getting good paint. That's one of my frustrations, but that'll be cured in a couple months. But my frustration right now is just learning how to draw. Throughout all the years and all the scrapbooking, I never really taught myself how to draw. So I struggle with that. Definitely, Terry, that is me. I am very, very different, very, very quirky, and I love. You are Carla. That's awesome. Yeah, I love being from there. I definitely hate Illinois. But, my grandbabies are here, so. It's the only reason why I moved back from Texas, because a couple years ago I had moved to Texas. Loved it there. But then when I found out my daughter-in-law was expecting, I had to come back home. These are not drawn. These are stamps that I fussy cut. But thank you, Terry. I am prefacing a little bit, like the flowers here, the bird was hand-drawn, these were hand-drawn. Yeah, definitely. My grandbabies are the love of my life. No, I'm a Gemini. Yeah, there's two of me. Yeah, I do, Mildred. Twice over, I have a 6-year-old granddaughter and a 2-year-old granddaughter. Yeah, a lot of people think I'm young. My God granted me with a baby face, and I'm 43 this year. Thank you, guys. Well, hello, Marl. When's your birthday? Mine's June 3rd. Yeah. Ask me how I feel every other day. Oh, let me stop the recording now, guys. I'm going to go ahead and stop the recording. Yeah, I mean, between all the medical female issues I've had and back surgery and that, which, I mean, I can walk, but there's pain 24 hours a day and dealing with all that. So, some days aren't so great. Yeah, I don't feel so young sometimes, though. But, life is good. Life has been good to me. I have, two great boys and two beautiful granddaughters, and I support myself and buy myself a house, and I get to enjoy time with you guys. So definitely, definitely doing okay. I guess I should have said goodbye to the YouTube people before I pressed stop recording, but oh well. Forgot about that. Yeah, I have fibro in RA, so that combined with the female issues and back issues and having had surgery and stuff for all of those things, some days aren't so great. And, thank you, Terry. I gotta say, and I know I probably sound like a broken record, but, being single for a long time, and my kids are kind of grown and that, and so I'm kind of on my own. And last few years, and then you guys really have made life great. And, you know, like I said, I've always done some kind of crafting or art, and I feel like I belong. So, yeah, that's me, Terry. I had surgery in 2011 because I was barely walking. Bye, Carla. Thanks for coming. So, yeah, you guys definitely, yeah, very, very much, I don't feel alone anymore. I feel like, you know, and it's really not about being alone, because I'm okay being by myself. I've been by myself now, like, my whole life. But it's the feeling like I have something in common, you know, because I have friends and stuff, but, you know, they don't do art, you know, and if you're not into art, if you're not an artist, you don't really understand, you don't get it. And with you guys, I feel like you get it. So, hi, Peggy. Same here. Definitely same here. Thanks for coming, Peggy. I don't know when you got here. I hope you were able to see a little bit. If not, I can show you the page we did today. Most definitely, Terry. Oh my God, most definitely. I know, Jean. You were saying that the other day when we were talking about it in one of the chats. And so if anybody can relate, it's you. I love you guys, honestly. Yeah, definitely, Peggy, definitely. Peggy, were you here to see the page that we did today? Okay, so this is, and you gotta guess what the theme of the page is. Can you see it there? I will give you a hint. It was it's dedicated and inspired by Jean. Hugs back to all you guys. Yes, Terry, you did it. Oh, I got to get your package out, Terry. It'll probably be next weekend, because I already missed the post office for today. Peggy, can you guess the theme of the page? Can you see the drawing in there? There's music, and let's see, it's dedicated to Jean, and there's a lock here and a chain.